a big, important approval for Amarin, also a big, important approval really for society. Some docs have phrased this to be the most important advance in preventative cardiovascular care in the last 30 years.
Tell us how many more patients you can now target with this drug than you were able to before the approval.
So previously we had a niche indication, an important niche indication, but it was for lowering triglycerides. Triglycerides are fats in your blood. You know, now we're looking at lowering cardiovascular risk. So if you think about statin therapy, and statins are important, they lower cardiovascular risk. So Lipitor, the most important, the largest used statin, lowers cardiovascular risk by about 25%. We lower cardiovascular risk by about 25% on top of their 25%. So this is millions of people.
Tell us about the market for this drug. You're charging a few thousand dollars on a list price per year, per patient, is that right? And the idea that you'll get reimbursement for that, what is the coverage like with the insurers? And how do you look at situations like we just saw with Sanofi saying it's getting out of cardiovascular disease because the market's not good?
So Amarin has done things that are a bit different. You know, we are a science-driven company out to try to help patients. You're right, Big Pharma has generally backed away from taking on addressing, you know, chronic ailments. They're really difficult to overcome, and the development of Vascepa has taken over a decade. Once we've gotten here, often for the breakthrough technology, someone will charge a very high price. We've taken the approach of charging a price that's a fraction of what other new drugs have been introduced at over the past decade. Very proud that in both October and November, two separate groups came out with cost analysis showing that Vascepa is not only cost effective, but will save society money by lowering and preventing costs of heart attacks and strokes, for example.
How high do your triglycerides need to be to make you a good candidate for this drug? And do you have to not respond to changes in diet to get it down earlier? I ask out of personal interest.
Not asking for a friend.
Yeah. So, you know, medical treatment would always encourage that folks, you know, focus on diet and exercise first. And also we're looking at patients here who have already tried statin therapy. But if you're on statin therapy or you don't respond well or aren't intolerant to statin therapy and have triglyceride levels at 150 mgs per deciliter, which is on the borderline of normal and high, Vascepa becomes something that might be considered. Now, the patients who are generally going to be looked at are patients with established disease. They might have had a cardiovascular event previously. They might have peripheral artery disease, coronary artery disease, problems with the carotid artery, or they might be diabetic and you know, have other risk factors as well. So, you know, we're not trying to treat healthy patients, but we're trying to treat patients who are at risk. And in the study of our drug, we found out that, you know, over a five-year period, you know, on average, one fewer major cardiovascular event was seen for every six patients treated. So that's a pretty significant reduction in cardiovascular events.
John, there are a lot of people out there who take fish oil to prevent heart disease. What's the difference between your drug and the fish oil you can buy at the store?
It works.
Is it higher potency? I imagine it's much stronger.
There's a lot of science. And, you know, if somebody is healthy and they're looking for supplements, there are a lot of supplements out there that might be worthwhile. But if you are sick and you're at risk for a cardiovascular event, really a proven therapy makes sense. There's been multiple studies done of dietary supplements and omega-3 mixtures, and they just haven't worked. There's a tremendous amount of science here. You know, if you were to take a classroom of students and go in and say, you know, solve a problem, you might find one that can solve that problem. You know, we've gone into fish oil, which is dozens of different ingredients, found the right ingredient. It's a fragile ingredient. We've extracted it without damaging it and then found a way to keep it stable. And we've gotten that to the right spot in the body. And by doing that, it performs very differently than your normal fish oil.
Before we let you go, we have to just quickly ask you about the next catalyst that investors are already looking at, which are the patent challenges to the drug. Can you tell us about, are you looking at a settlement? Are we going to trial early January?
So I think there are a lot of catalysts. We're looking for approval for this drug in Canada. We just filed in Europe. We're looking for completion of a clinical trial in China as well. This is a major drug. Anytime you have a major drug, you always have patent challenges. We're confident in our patents, and we're intending to defend those vigorously.
All right, John, thank you so much for joining.